Elon Musk has been warning people about the risks of AI-powered bots for years, even anticipating scary outcomes similar to those in the Terminator. But now, he appears to be taking things into his own hands in order to save humankind from becoming extinct. The electric vehicle company is set to create a humanoid robot prototype, aptly termed the Tesla bot. As expected, social media was flooded with comparisons to a slew of sci-fi films about intelligent machines that go terribly wrong. Clearly, everyone has been eagerly waiting to know all they can about this bot. So what exactly will this bot be able to do? And how exactly is it going to look like? Let us find out as we delve deeper into the subject. Welcome to Future, your daily dose of tech content. Today, we'll go over the details of Elon Musk's incredible new upgraded Tesla bot. So before getting into it, make sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe to our channel. Let's get started. It is always exciting to see the next bot making its move into the commercial market space. So the news is that Musk's robot is being built by his firm, Tesla. It seems to be a divergence from the business's car-making industry until you realize that Tesla isn't your ordinary automaker after all. On the other hand, the so-called Tesla bot is a concept for a sleek, 125-pound humanoid robot that will use Tesla's vehicle artificial intelligence integrated with autopilot capabilities. Now, with that kind of technology, the possibilities are simply innumerable. It's a head fitted with the autopilot cameras used by Tesla's cars to monitor the environment, organize and follow routes, manage traffic by dodging pedestrian hurdles, and it will also have a display panel for information. On the other hand, the robot's arrival came after a 9-minute lecture explaining some of the AI enhancements. Driving Tesla's electric vehicles, including the Dojo supercomputer, assist their cars in navigating city streets without the need for human intervention. The car's interference engine will maintain all the neural nets to identify the environment, along with a Dojo supercomputer and the Tesla chip, packaged into an elegant white bodysuit with a shining black mask. Musk stated that the bot was not designed to assist Tesla with production, although the company is creating many of the processors required for robotics. According to the developers at D1 Dojo Chips, it has a 7-nanometer capability. A GPU-level computer plus CPU connection is also included on the chip, and double the I/O bandwidth of today's state-of-the-art connectivity switch chips. It makes perfect sense for Tesla to construct a robot, and this one is most definitely meant to be the ultimate standard. We're also adept at sensors and batteries, as Musk said, and will most likely have a prototype that appears like this next year. But in addition to the positive aspects, the Tesla bot comes with a slew of new dangers, including potential concerns about privacy and autonomy, as the bot gathers and acts on highly sensitive data. However, there are concerns about how humans would accept and react to humanoid robots. As a result, there may be inconsistencies in ethical or ideological positions. With tremendous power comes tremendous responsibilities. But the issue is whether Tesla will be able to achieve it by the end of next year. All we have to say is, certainly, and why not? However, the most difficult part isn't developing a robot. It's getting that machine to perform valuable things of interest. We believe this is going to be super challenging for Musk. People with lots of robotics expertise frequently tend to think that once you build the robot, you've addressed the majority of the issue. As a result, they concentrate on mechanical aspects such as actuators, as well as how it will seem and what it can fit along with others. But that's wrong. The most difficult challenges arise after you've built a mechanically viable robot, and it's likely, perhaps probable, that Tesla will develop a Tesla bot by next year. Musk discussed how he believes it would not appear like the concept renderings in its presentation. It'll be capable of standing and walking, maybe with the ability to withstand a few tosses and do some rudimentary object identification and grasping. He went on to say that development would be gradual. However, trying to match the level of excellence with Boston Dynamics or Agile Robots is going to be a task. Perhaps they'll end up with a SIMO with an APR tool that can produce great samples. However, it is ultimately futile. Nevertheless, we may call it a victory if Tesla ends up spending time and money on tackling some truly difficult robotics challenges by cooperating with these firms. But, like every other time, how long would it take to ultimately launch the bots on Mars? Well, Musk said that he is pretty optimistic that SpaceX and Tesla's bots will put people on Mars by 2026, and that it is a goal that can be achieved in approximately 5 years. However, it is evident that establishing a Martian colony would need a significant amount of effort. As we all know, this is his ultimate aim, but hundreds of Tesla bots can actually assist humans in creating the foundations of human exploration on Mars real fast. Tesla's consistent advertising has drawn a lot of attention as people attempt to find out where and when the robot will be created and constructed. Although Tesla is now building a massive factory in Austin, Texas, the majority of job listings for the robot are currently placed in Palo Alto, California. A prototype of the 5-foot-8-inch robot is due in 2022. Still, we're skeptical of the timeline, given Elon Musk's prior pronouncements of fast-moving grand plan initiatives that never occurred or were severely delayed in the implementation phase. So, we're just going to have to wait to find out. How much will it cost you to purchase your own Tesla robot? Well, Musk hasn't given a price for the Tesla bot, but there's a lot of conjecture online about what it would cost. Before stopping manufacturing earlier this year, SoftBank Robotics sold its house companion Pepper humanoid robot for approximately $1,800. However, because of Tesla's fantastic technology, many people believe their robot will cost $10,000 or maybe more. There could be a one-time purchase charge for the robot, followed by a monthly membership fee. Musk also emphasized that the firm has no plans to make them available for military or armed purposes. However, before we get too worked up about the morality of using these things in various contexts, we need to grasp the programmatic constraints of what they can accomplish. However, we think that since we're discussing a Tesla product, a lot of the systems will be heavily restricted, and altering their programs to allow them to carry or operate a weapon would be difficult. Because they'll have the ML plus AI capabilities of vehicles, programming them to be utilized or designing them for humans will be constrained some way or the other. Their capacity to digest data will be similar to what autonomous cars are capable of. We already know that Tesla's autonomous driving capability leaves a lot to be desired. Still, if they do have wireless network connectivity such as 5G, they might have additional processing and intelligence run from a cloud data center. It would be far more potent than that of a localized CPU, so nobody knows what type of decision-making capabilities these robots will possess, or whether they may be more of a teleoperated gadget, such as a drone with movable hands. Personally, we are optimistic that these robots will be helpful. Clearly, Musk envisions humanity eventually transcending its evolutionary origins via technology that is beyond humans. However, before technology could become superhuman, it must first be human, or at the very least, be built to live in a society created by humans. So what are your thoughts on this next-level bot? Do you believe the cost will be reasonable? Let us know in the comments below. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to subscribe to our channel to never miss a video from us. That concludes today's video. Thank you for watching!